We don't have too many trends per se in any surgery, but what I would like to say is that bariatric surgery is on the rise. There is more acceptability because of the fact that a lot of people are getting very, very good results, and long term we are not having too many complications of this procedure. So bariatric surgery numbers have gradually gone up in this country. It's probably because of the various good results that have come out over the last 15 to 20 years of bariatric surgery in India. We've had more and more celebrities, we've had more and more relevant people getting this surgery done and actually become brand ambassadors of the good results of this surgery. One of the biggest problems that we do have in India is type 2 diabetes. And a lot of the obese diabetics today no longer have to take insulin, no longer have to take a lot of the medications that they used to take once upon a time. They're living better, healthier lives. And that's why the surgery, which was once upon a time captioned as just weight loss surgery or something which was almost likened to liposuction or abdominoplasties, today that cosmetic angle has completely gone away from bariatric surgery, and we liken it more to a healthier option of sustained weight loss with better health effects. India stands number 3 in terms of the obesity numbers worldwide, and we stand number 2 in terms of the type 2 diabetes numbers worldwide. So in terms of the diabesity epidemic, which forms the most important part of the non-communicable diseases, and we know that non-communicable diseases is killing more people today in India than infectious diseases or various other diseases. So if we look at it from that point of view, today we are number 2 or number 3 in the world in terms of the disease burden population. What we are doing, we have very, very few options, and the amount of money which is being spent in terms of expenditure, we have very, very little that we are spending in terms of the obesity epidemic. So it's time that we sit up and take notice about this. So today, most of the obesity associations and most of the diabetes associations of the world have acknowledged that bariatric surgery probably forms one of the most important fulcrums of or spokes in the wheel of treatment profile long term. The American Diabetes Association, the International Diabetes Federation, or the Diabetes Surgery Summit have all pronounced that if you're obese and if you're diabetic and if you've tried medication and not had results, or you're worsening in terms of the medications you're taking, or the disease of diabetes is worsening, it's about time that you consider bariatric surgery or metabolic surgery as an option. So as Asians and Indians, we have some gene called as a thrifty gene. Now, thrifty gene makes all of us from our days when we are born to the days that we survive more prone to diabetes and obesity-related diseases. So when we are born, our skeleton and muscle mass is much less as compared to a Caucasian. So we have more fat percentage in our bodies genetically. We have a genetic predilection towards abdominal obesity, and that leads to various problems like metabolic syndrome. So dyslipidemia, type 2 diabetes, and hypertension all form one fulcrum, and that eventually leads to coronary artery disease, and that leads to a host of problems that we would rather avoid. Challenges is that obesity is still not proclaimed as a disease. India is still tackling with malnutrition on one hand and obesity. For the government, it's a challenge, because if they talk about obesity, then it's almost like they're not talking about the poor people. The problem is that today there is a huge proportion of low-income group and even slum population which is suffering from obesity. Most of the economically cheap food is actually cause of obesity, and that's the junk food that we do consume today. So the day we declare obesity as a disease, that day everything else will change. Our mindsets will change, and we'll start thinking much, much better in terms of curing obesity. Obesity is the mother of all diseases. Today, there is a host of diseases, right from intracranial hypertension to sleep apnea to gastroesophageal reflux disease, gallstones, pancreatitis, infertility, host of cancers, all are linked to obesity. Leave alone metabolic syndrome. So if we consider the mothership of all diseases, obesity, let's tackle obesity. But yet we've not declared it as a disease in India. I think it's time that the government starts taking concrete steps towards maybe not taking obesity as a disease, but treating diabesity, because we don't have the economic prowess to tackle this disease. We're losing more man-loss hours every single day. We have a huge population of young onset diabetics, and these young onset diabetics are suffering more in life and dying much younger. So eventually it's going to affect that generation of young Indians who are going to be our future, who is our present right now. So it's about time that we do something about it. Until recently, the top three ministers of our government were suffering with obesity-related diabetes. Mr. Venkaiah Naidu, Mr. Gadkari, as well as Mr. Arun Jaitley. All three have had bariatric surgery and have had really good outcomes. One's gone on to become the Vice President of India. We've had so many popular Bollywood stars. For example, if you look at only obesity, you've had an 85 kilo weight loss in someone like Ganesh Acharya, who we operated just a year and a half back. Recently in the limelight has been Hrithik Roshan's sister, because Hrithik posted a picture of her transformation of around a 60-65 kilo weight loss. It's not only about the way these people have lost weight. What it has done is it's got them back their life. It's got them doing what they always wanted to do. So for a politician, he's got back his political career. For a dance choreographer, he can do the dance moves. For someone like Sunaina, she's got back, got out of depression, now can face the world and face his challenges. And these are the things that bariatric surgery does. It gives you back your life.